Alright then, so we've just met up with our team, or one of them, dealt with the aliens. Now they've got armour that's made out of bone, so I don't know if that's a natural thing. You know, the bone's like a natural defence to them, or it's you know, actual armour plating that they use, made out of bone for some reason. Because bones, I mean bone. I don't think bone would be that strong. Of course, I could be wrong. I mean, the femur's supposedly the strongest bone in the body, but that can break. Anyway, so yeah, at this point, I still hadn't worked out what those boxes were for. It's only until much later on. I don't know what that is. That red one. Health, possibly. Probably. Anyway, so we're moving along, we're looking for our teammates. So
it's gear from one of our shuttles. Good. The atmospheric sensor is still working. Let me guess. It says don't breathe the air? Yeah, but no sign of industrial pollutants. That's not what killed this place. And no radioactive isotopes either, so nobody nukes the place.
Yes, anyway, so we're looking for our team members.
Need that?
And there you go, you can see. So I thought that potentially it was only the first two guys that were, you know, hostile. Turns out that all of them are dicks, so I lost a teammate. Obviously I could have restarted, but what's the point of, you know, restarting, making everything perfect? You know, I wanted to see what happened. I waited. Unfortunately, it turns out that their entire race is just a bunch of dicks. Or possibly this is like a splinter faction, and they don't represent the main race in any way. It's a possibility. Something I was thinking about. There's a couple of plot points I was thinking about that could possibly, you know, be a twist. Because you know there's going to be a twist at some point. It's Mass Effect, and it's a Mass Effect game. It's going to be a number of twists along the way.
I can't believe we're doing this. Did Captain make it?
Anyway, so I had to check on my teammate, and yeah, he's dead.
No vital signs. Just shot him in cold blood. He was trying to surrender. Why kill him? Would we treat them any different if they showed up on Earth armed to the teeth?
I don't think that's a valid thing to say, to be honest. But there you go.
We'll come back for his body once we find the others.
Hope Greer's still Spoiler, alive we don't.
Still, take a look at this architecture. This is really something.
Anyway, so yes, I've picked up an assault rifle now. So now I've got an assault rifle to use.
Never seen anything like it. Looks to be at least 3 or 4 centuries old.
The Ark left 600 years ago, right?
Yeah, our long-range scans wouldn't have shown this. These structures, that tower, maybe none of it was here when we left the Milky Way. Okay, now this is weird. Even with these readings, I have no idea what it does.
Just imagine the mind that invented it.
If that's even possible, evolution separated from ours by 2 million light years.
Spooky when you put it that way.
Yes, there's a lot of alien machinery and ruins lying about. What they do at this point is unknown. I thought that was a jumping spot, but it turns out that it's not. It just looks like that. So yeah, there's a lot of... that's nothing to scan, I thought it was. Yeah, there's nothing there, nothing up there. So I just left it. There's a load more light sources. There's another thing. So it's all unknown technology at this point. Because of the electrical storm, the AI is offline, so it cannot give us any analysis on the stuff. Now there's some containers with items to pick up. I just took them all. I haven't actually looked at that yet.
Hey, look, flares going off over there.
There's some flares going off over there. Now you do get some optional missions, as you can see in the top right. So yes, this is one of the new creatures, a bit like the Baron. Obviously, it's kind of closer to a hammerhead shark. As you can see, it's got bone.
No sign of technology.
Well, so
this is what makes me think that it's
yeah, weird.
It like grows on them as opposed to plating, because that guy's got the same bone armor, and I don't think they would have put the armor on the dogs or the whatever they are. The quadrupeds. Anyway, so we're looking around. I was just looking for stuff to scan because things aren't really all that clearly labelled. Now we're looking through the wreckage of our ship.
I can't believe we survived this.
We're not on planet yet. And
shit, moving on our perimeter. It's an ambush.
And then we're ambushed. So I was trying to stack into the air and fire, which is obviously a terrible idea because then the rest of the enemies just can shoot you. Now at this point I was having trouble seeing where the enemies were actually coming from. There's so much smoke and they kind of blend in a little bit. I didn't see, there's a guy right behind that box right there right in front of me. And I didn't see him at all because he kind of just blended in with the rocks. And it took me a while to actually see him. Health doesn't regenerate the same as the shield does in previous games. I think Mass Effect 2 did it. I can't remember about number 3. But the health would completely regenerate as soon as the shield was full. Just take all.
I used to guard a Mass Effect relay.
Wish we'd had one for the Orcs. Maybe we should see if there's anything else useful here.
So now we're just told to look around the wreckage to see if we can find anything. And there is a flight recorder, a black box. It's mentioned briefly. The guy says, "Oh, here's the flight recorder," and I had no idea what he was referring to. I was looking around, you know, up and down, all over, and I was about to give up on it, and then I did actually find it eventually. Scanning another life form, but it appears that once you've scanned one, you've scanned them all, which makes sense. So he says here's the flight recorder, and I had no idea what he was referring to. I thought it was like a small box on the floor, but it turns out it's that massive console just over there. Yeah, just to the left, behind me now. To the right. I'll see it in a minute. I'll spend a couple of minutes looking around for... There you go, it's that big blue thing there. I thought it was something small on the ground because he brought it up as soon as I went to all those bits and pieces. And then eventually I find it. Eventually. But yeah, no, I was about to give up, and then I decided to say sod it, and then luckily I found it. After that, I wanted to get a better view of the place. I wanted to see what we were, you know, what we were up against, what the area was like. Unfortunately, for a game that's supposed to be all about, you know, letting you travel and explore, I couldn't climb up this rock. It wouldn't let me. There's just an invisible wall. So that idea was put to bed, put to rest, pretty much instantly. Now we had a couple of optional objectives to find somebody and something else, and I was trying to find out where they were exactly. What I didn't realise is this little valley is kind of like a U-shaped type deal. So it goes back on itself.
Structure up that hill. This place is taking a beating from storms, along with everything else on this planet.
So yes, it's more useless, unknown technology. Doesn't really do anything. Gives me some research points though, and research points are supposedly used to make new weapons and armor. So that's something. I got hit by a lightning storm. Anyway, so we're investigating this alien structure.
Well, let's hope no one's home.
And
no
idea what it does. No idea what kind of tech it is. Or who it belonged to. But I was at first expecting, you know, I thought it belonged to the other aliens, the Ket that we've been fighting.
No one's living here.
But then I put my gun away and just decided to scan shit instead. I could always get my gun out in, you know, like an instant.
Who knows? Let's call it a weird alien machine. Joel could use Sam right about now. What's all this about? You guessed it. Another weird alien machine.
Huh. Figures.
Only one way to find out.
You mean turn it on?
Same language as those aliens. Wonder what he's saying. Kill old humans, probably? Nothing. Another weird alien machine. Oh shit.
That can't be good. Oh.
So the weird alien machine is a generator.
Yeah, sure. Why wouldn't it be?
Maybe it did something. Huh. door open. Some kind of research lab? Maybe. Then it got hit by a tornado. Not exactly poetry, is it? Weird. You hear that? Looks like they were trying to tunnel in. Don't think it turned out so well. Whatever this is. Watch it! What is it? Piss? So now killer robots too? The Geth back home would love this place. Some serious energy on the other side of that door. Maybe it's closed for a reason. These guys were poking around where they shouldn't have. It's fried. Could be a console of some sort. For that door. His wounds look like they're from an energy blast. Might have tangled with our robot friend there. Theories, recall specialist? There's some kind of technology on this planet. Older. Underground. Something these aliens are interested in. Like, weather's still crappy.
Anyway, so yes, we went through the alien ruins. And there's a new enemy type, some sort of robot. Unknown robot. And unfortunately, I was not expected to be ambushed. I got ambushed, and then that weird four-legged beast trapped me in a corner. Now this fight doesn't actually go, I thought that was the enemy, but he came out in the corner in a weird fashion. I tried fighting them off from the corners, using the corners as an advantage. It doesn't work too well. I mean, it works somewhat, but it's not great. And in the end, I believe they get me, and in the end I just end up running past them, just to the next mission.
not wait around for more.
So I was trying to redo what I tried to do earlier. This time, I mean, I thought I was supposed to rescue my friend, and I thought he was on top of that rock. So I was trying to use this rock to get up there, and to, you know, I thought I was going to jump up there and fly up, but it turns out there's just another invisible wall. And anyway, so we're running down. I'm looking for my teammates at this point, trying to find out where he is. It turns out, like I said, this goes around in a U shape, and he's in like a tiny little cave tucked away.
A path down the right.
At first, I thought that was something, but it was just a rock.
Yeah, radio static, but like a pattern.
Anyway, so we're going along, and there's some more guys, and this time I decided not to take any chances. I just opened fire instantly. Unfortunately, my teammate decided to block me and blow me up and kill me, or get me killed. So we had to restart, and now I had to, unfortunately, the checkpoint system. The save system on this game is odd. If you're in like a main mission, then you can't save whenever you want. You have to rely on the autosave feature, which is a fucking stupid idea. Being forced to rely on the autosave feature is a terrible, terrible idea. I don't know why games have it. By all means, have the autosave feature, but don't force people to use it. You know, don't force people to have that as the only saving method. Because once you get halfway through a firefight, you've got to go out, maybe you've got to do something, etc. And you turn it off, and then you come back, and you realise, oh, I've got to do that last quest and this firefight again, or you know, the last objective and this firefight again, because it didn't auto save. I mean, it's a minor thing, but it's something that annoys me. It must annoy enough people. Anyway, so yeah, I didn't take any chances with these guys. I instantly just shot them because I knew, you know, they were probably would have killed that guy if I didn't do anything. So I opened fire instantly, just took him down. I mean, that other guy that died, that might have just been scripted. Of course, I don't know. I didn't find out. It could have been a scripted death, or it might not have been.
You okay?
Hey. Yeah. Where are the others?
They killed Kirkland, but Fisher's alive, back at the crash site.
He's got a broken leg, needs help. I'll check around for supplies, then head back.
Stay put when you get there. We'll look for my dad's shuttle.
Good luck. Can't wait to get off this rock.
Break your neck.
the whole patrol! No one is to drag us off like grid. Push them back!
I was mistaken. Earlier I said these guys got me and I ran past them back at that alien ship. It was these guys. These guys are the that's one of the broken spacebar things. My spacebar's broken, so it's that extra sensitive. And I end up accidentally, you know, using my jet boosters. I went to save my teammate and that instantly got me killed, so I decided against that in future ones. But yeah, these guys got me like once or twice. And then I thought, fuck it, I'll just run right past them to the mission objective. And of course that caused those enemies behind me to despawn. And always good. But yeah, no, I died here like once or twice. Obviously I'm playing on insanity difficulty, so I'm playing on the hardest because that's what you do. Well, I mean, that's what I do at least anyway. I play on the hardest just because, you know, games aren't really that much of a challenge anymore.
Long drop.
Yeah. I was looking for a shortcut and I couldn't find it. And in the end, I just said, you know what, fuck it. I'm just gonna run past them. I can't be bothered to deal with them. I'm just gonna leave them. I'm just gonna run past. And they took a couple of shots at me. But thankfully for the jump jets, maneuverability is is much improved in this game. You know, you no longer have to take cover to climb something. Anyway, so we've regrouped with our team and the shuttle, and they're under heavy fire, and we're coming in.
I'm on it.
And it's back up. Now this fight gave me a little bit of trouble until I decided to hang back, basically. Your teammates are actually fairly competent in this game, which surprised me because the previous games they weren't all that great. You know, they were okay, but a lot of the time they didn't really help too much. But this game they seem to be fairly decent at you know, holding out, holding their own, as people say. There's a graphical glitch over there. Some guys spazzing it out.
Harry, you guys okay?
I was just looking. Like I said, I found it quite hard to see them. They seem to have like a natural camouflage in this area. I hope that's not a thing. I hope that's just, you know, just their design. What I mean is, I hope they don't have like a camouflage effect, like a chameleon. I hope they can't just change their colours and blend into areas. I hope that is their set design. It just seems that their arms and their heads blend in really well with the rocks, and their bodies are kind of match the grass, so they all kind of blend together. So I am really hoping that they don't have like a natural camouflage effect, and that they have, you know, just a standard default look. So I tried to use the jump jets to see fire at him, but he decided to move as soon as I did.
Well, that settled that. Cavalry to the rescue. Nice to see you guys. You too, Harry. How is everyone?
Still in one piece. You got here just in time.
Where's my dad?
He went scouting ahead while we fixed the shuttle. Ryder, there's weapons and ammo at the shuttle. Stock up.
Did these things try talking to you at all?
Barely a word, then started shooting. What about you?
We tried being nice. They didn't play along.
Anyway, so as I was looking for weapons and equipment, it turns out that they'd sent for reinforcements, and now we've got this ship. I was trying to scan the ship because I assumed the ship would be something to scan. Turns out I was wrong. You can see all dropping down. So yeah, this fight here, this is the one that gave me a bit of trouble. I think I died once or twice and then I just had to hang back. Now, funny enough, I didn't see that grenade when I was playing the first time. So I had no idea what got me, but I noticed it the just then, now that I'm talking over it. I guess now that I'm not focused on, you know, which enemies are popping up, which ones aren't. And where they're popping up from. But yes, so you can see my teammate's down, so I actually just ignored him this time, because the first time I went to heal him, he just got me killed. So I kind of ignored him. I died anyway, at some point. And then I have another go. And I noticed the dropship animation. You'll see it in a second once I've died and come back to life, or we start the checkpoint or whatever. There's pretty much no animation for the troopers. They kind of just fall out of that. It's like they're on a conveyor belt basically. They kind of just slide along, and then they just like fall out of the ship one by one.
You're shitting me. Sound off.
I'm here. I can't get a beat on those things!
There's too many of them! Just keep firing, we can do this!
Where the hell are you going?
The fight's back here!
So here we go, this is where I noticed the animation. You can see the dropship there, and then I look up and I see them, they sort of just slide off and fall down.
They got balls to try an airdrop.
There's just not really any animation for that, they just slide and fall off. But yeah, this is where I'm leaving it for this episode, apparently. There's a grenade, I saw that one, but I was still struggling with the controls at that point, but I'm going to leave it here.